Come now. Amen. Yes. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Amen. It's good to know him in a real way. Amen. To have a relationship with him. Amen. To know that he's working effectually in your life. Amen. And what a God we serve. We don't deserve it. We deserve hell. Amen. But God, amen, stepped in the midst of our wicked, corrupt life. Amen. That deserved hell. Amen. And gave us an opportunity to be saved. Amen. He didn't force any of us to be saved, but he gave us an opportunity to be saved. Amen. And I'm so glad for the day that I called on him. Amen. All right. Anything else before we go? Thanksgiving. Amen.
Be thankful unto him and bless his name.
Bless his name.
I want to do that tonight, amen. I want to thank
him
for praising. He answered a great prayer for us this week.
Praise the Lord.
As a family, when Denise and I had the kidney transplant, some people, different ones, recommended that we apply for medical assistance on our insurance. You know, thanks be to God, already had insurance. All that, but since we were going to be having to pay for the new medications and all that, you know, they recommended, so we did that. And to God be the glory, He approved it. He let it be approved.
Amen.
We got the coverage last year, so this year it was up for a renewal this week. And we went Monday, and you know, I had got a, thanks be to God, got a raise on my salary. Amen. And so I was afraid, you know, that might throw us out.
Amen.
It wasn't a struggle or nothing. We went in there and submitted the application. And thanks be to God, the lady walked out and he said, you're approved.
Amen.
I just want to thank him for praying. And, you know,
yes.
To have all that covered, brother, and to know that that's going to be taken care of.
Amen.
That all that's covered under the insurance. And
yes. Amen. Yes. Yes, amen. 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 Brother Perry was talking about praying about that on the Lord's Day. Amen. We praise the Lord with you, brother, that God was able to work some things out. Our God still answers prayer. Amen. And he's able. Anything else before we go into the text tonight? Amen. Amen. It's good to be saved. Amen. Good to be in the house of the Lord. I know the Lord saves, amen, I'm saved. Amen. I know I'm saved, amen, so I know that he saves. All right, Matthew chapter number 19 tonight. Matthew chapter number 19. You're not tired of the husband and wife relationship yet, are you? Amen. We've tried, amen, to go carry it on to other places, amen, in this dealing with our homes, amen, but God keeps bringing us back to husband and wife, and husband and wife, I guess more so, I guess we about got Jacob and Faith not long from now going to be getting married. Amen. And so I guarantee you they're going to be some learning experiences along the way. Amen. And there's some in here that can tell you been married for quite a while. Probably some in here been married 30 plus years, maybe, I guess. And Brother Perry and him has. Amen. Praise the Lord for that. That didn't come easy, did it, brother? Amen. I guarantee you, amen. It ain't all been easy, but God, amen, has saw through. Amen. We've been married 20 plus years and many others 10 plus years, 5 years, a year. Amen. Some weeks, amen, and months and maybe even a year or so. But you know what? The same God, amen, that kept us a year has kept us 20 and 30 years. Amen. And it's going to have to be by his grace and by his help, amen, that he'll keep us the rest of the way. Amen. All right. We're going to look in chapter 19. Here's just a springboard tonight from our text where we'll be looking at. The Bible said in verse 1, and it came to pass that when Jesus had finished these sayings, he departed from Galilee and came unto the coast of Judea beyond Jordan. And great multitudes followed him and healed them there. The Pharisees also came unto him, tempting him, and saying unto him, now listen, the Pharisees showed up that day. They didn't have no legitimate question to ask. You follow me there? Amen. They showed up wanting to tempt him. Amen. And the Bible said here, it said, tempting him and saying unto him, is it lawful for a man to put away his wife for every cause? And he answered and said unto them, have you not read that he which made them at the beginning made them male and female? It's still male and female. Amen. Amen. Notice he said at the beginning, amen, him that made him at the beginning made them male and female. It's still male and female. Even all these years later, all these decades later, amen, God ain't changed his mind on male and female. Amen. And you know, I thought something else this week too, amen. You know, God could have just as easy, he could have just as easily created Eve out of the dust of the ground as he did Adam. Amen, but he didn't. Amen. He took Eve from Adam. Yeah. Amen. Yeah. And he took one and made two. Yeah. Wasn't too long after that, he took the two and made them one again. Amen. What about that? Amen. That'll help us tonight. Amen. Yeah. Now listen here. That means there had to be some sacrifice involved right out of the gate. Amen. Adam had to be willing to sacrifice. Yeah. Amen. There's going to be some sacrifice in your marriage life. Amen. I promise you. Now, I want you to notice this here. He said in verse 4, and he answered and said unto them, have you not read that he which made them at the beginning made them male and female? And said, for this cause shall a man leave father and mother, amen, and shall cleave to his wife, and they twain shall be one flesh. Wherefore, they are no more twain, but one flesh. What therefore God had joined together, let no man put asunder. Father in heaven, we thank you, Lord, for your goodness. Lord, thank you for your love and your mercy. God, your grace. God, been sufficient, Lord, through the years. Lord, I thank you for my wife. And Lord, thank you for what she's meant to me, God, and how you've helped us through the years, Lord, to maintain, Lord God, our marriage. And Lord God, be happy, Lord God, in the situation, Lord God, as it is. And we thank you so much for it. Lord, we look forward to the days ahead, God, in serving you. And Lord, I pray that you bless tonight. Help us, Lord, as we study your word one more time. And we'll give you glory in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. I'm interested tonight in bringing our text here out of verse number 5. And it said, and said, for this cause shall a man leave father and mother and shall cleave to his wife, and they shall be, the twain shall be one flesh. And I noticed that, and we talked about that word cleave at one time, and we talked about it being the leaving and the cleaving, and we talked about how God joined them together, Brother Brad, and how what God had joined together, amen, that means to be welded together, and the two is joined together in such a way that they can't be separated without it doing harm to the both of them, amen. Have you ever seen something that's welded together? And you try to tear it apart and it just makes a mess out of everything. Amen. That's sort of the principle that God's showing us here with marriage. Amen. And he's talking about that leaving and that cleaving. Amen. And the twain shall be made one flesh. And wherefore they are no more twain but one flesh. Amen. And we want to talk about that tonight in this principle. Amen. Having said that on living happy ever after marriage, amen. Living happy ever after marriage, amen. Now, I know there'll be some that'll say that's only in the fairy tales, amen. But I'll report to you tonight that you can live happy after marriage, amen. All marriages, amen, ain't in a mess, amen. And marriage, when it's done by the principles of this book, it can be a blessed thing, amen. Can I tell you, it can be a happy place, amen. I want to say unto you, friend, it don't get to be a happy place easy, amen. There's a lot of hard work, amen, and a lot of effort put forth, amen, by both husband and wife. If we're going to have a happy marriage, amen, and we're going to live happy ever after, amen. I don't know about you, but I'm interested, amen, in living happy ever after, amen. I don't want my home to be a miserable place, amen. I don't want my marriage to be a miserable place, amen. I want it to be one that glorifies God, amen, that resembles Christ's love for His church, amen. There's going to be some sacrifice involved, amen, but I want to tell you, friend, you, my friend, tonight, Jacob and Faith about to get married for long, I submit to you tonight by God's word that you can live happy ever after, amen. Now I want you to know tonight you're coming to this place, amen, before marriage, and boy, no doubt to Jacob, amen, Faith, amen, is the perfect will of God, amen. And you know what she is, amen, she makes him happy, amen. And no doubt he can't wait till the day, amen, that they're joined together in holy matrimony. And likewise, Faith the same way, amen. I want you to know, amen, can't wait to get there. I can't wait to see them tonight, amen. No doubt the days go by when they're away from each other, they communicate, amen, by telephone or whatever ways you communicate, amen. But nothing like seeing each other, amen. It's happy time, amen. Y'all know exactly. Now, some of you, amen, it's been too long, amen. It's been too long and it's no longer happy time, amen. But they know very well what I'm talking about tonight, amen. I'm telling you, friend, that's right, amen. And then all of a sudden, amen, you know, I've seen a lot of situations, amen, start off that way, amen. Couldn't wait to see one another, couldn't wait to get in one another's presence, amen. I'm telling you, friend, the butterflies are flying, and man, he couldn't do no wrong. She couldn't make any mistakes, and man, this is the best thing ever happened to me in my life, amen. I want to tell you, that's the way it ought to stay, amen. It ought to stay that way, amen. But you know what? God, amen, has a plan for us, amen, to live happy ever after marriage, amen. Can I tell you, it's going to take both of you, amen. It won't be a one-sided affair. It'll take both of you, amen, putting a lot of hard work in. It's going to take some effort, amen. It's going to take some determination. It's going to take, my friend, more than what you able to do by your own power, amen. You're going to have to trust God. You're going to have to believe He is able, amen, to keep you, amen. Think about this, amen. I want to give you some things tonight that will help you in your marriage to live happy ever after marriage, amen. I'm talking about, how do you say I do, amen. How do you go back, amen, to the house and the I do's already been done and the newness wears off, the honeymoon's over, amen. You get back from your honeymoon, the vacation time's over, a reality sets in, and I've got a brand new life now. I've got a responsibility as a husband. I've got a responsibility as a wife, amen. And now reality sets in, I've got to get back up and go back to work, amen. And boy, I've got to maintain the house. And you know what? You can do all that, amen, and be just as happy as if you were still on your honeymoon, amen. That's exactly right, amen. I want you to know, my friend, this society that we live in has no value for marriage, amen. I want to tell you, they'll tell you the first problem that arises, I'm convinced in our day, amen, that people think that if you're in a marriage, amen, and problems rise up and you have some disagreements, that it cannot be the will of God, amen. I want to tell you, nothing could be further from the truth, amen. I want to tell you, friend, you can marry the perfect person, the one God intends you to marry, amen, and be in the perfect will of God and still have problems arise, amen. I want to tell you, you're not just alike, amen. You're going to have some differences, amen. I want you to turn to Luke chapter number 6 tonight, amen. I'll give you four things, amen, I believe that'll keep your marriage a happy place, amen. It'll cause you to live happy ever after marriage, amen. After you get married, amen, Brother Perry, you can still be happy, amen. I've been married for 23 years. We had a lot of rough times, amen. We had a lot of hard times. I want to tell you, when we got married, brother, we was head over heels over each other, amen. And praise God, 23 years later, still head over heels, amen. Happy in Jesus, amen. I know better now than I knew then, amen. It's been a lot of bumpy roads along the way, amen. But God's been good, amen. And He's helped us through a lot of things, amen. I want you to notice, first of all, in verse 47, the Bible said, whosoever cometh to me and heareth my sayings and doeth them, I will shew you to whom he is like. He is like a man which built an house and digged deep and laid the foundation on a rock, and when the floods came and the streams beat vehemently immediately upon the house and could not shake it, for it was founded upon a rock. Amen. Can I say tonight, friend, in order to live happy ever after, you're going to have to keep your foundation right. Amen. That's exactly right. Amen. I want you to know, friend, you're going to have to dig deep. Amen. And you're going to have to find a rock. Amen. And that is the Lord Jesus. Amen. And Him alone. Brother Cliff, you know there'll be times in your life, in your marriage, friend, things start getting shook up. Amen. Can I go on and tell you tonight, just so you know, Brother Jacob, amen, and Miss Faith, you need to know this tonight, that your marriage is going to be put on trial. Amen. That's exactly right. Amen. The devil will see to it. Amen. He'll make it happen. I want you to know that. Amen. It's going to be put through the test. Amen. Ain't going to be some testing times. I want you to know, anybody here that's been married any time at all, if you're married tonight, amen, whether it's been a week or a year or 30 years, amen, you would agree, amen, that they're going to be some testing times, amen. I don't care how much you love him. I don't care how much you love her. I don't care how much you alike, amen. I want you to know they're going to be some times of trial. They're going to be some times of testing, amen. And I want you to know, amen, there'll be some times when the tears begin to roll, amen. It's going to be some days, amen, that you wonder, how did it get from where we was at the marriage altar saying I do to where it is today, amen. But I want you to know, my friend, the only way you're going to be able to withstand that is to dig deep, amen, and make sure your foundation is kept right, amen. It can't be by what I think or what I want to do, amen. It's always got to be what he says, amen. Hear it, these sayings of his, amen, and do it them. Can I tell you, friend, you're going to have to make up your mind. You know what happened, Brother Hope? Here in our text, amen, that man, he dug deep, amen. Brother Perry, you'll find there was two men, amen. Both of them, amen, was there. One man dug deep, amen, and he founded his house upon a rock, amen. Can I tell you, friend, this man that dug deep, the flood still came, amen. I want to tell you, it still came, amen. It don't matter how deep you dig, amen, and the foundation being right, amen, the flood waters are still going to come, amen. It don't matter how much you read, how much you pray, amen, how much you hold hands, amen, how much you cuddle up, hey, I want to tell you, friend, the flood waters are still going to come, amen. There's going to be some testing times, amen. The devil will try to cause the littlest misunderstandings, amen, as he can. He won't come in there with a great big thing all the time. It'll be some little something that he'll want to make something real big out of it. And before you know it, my friend, you start getting shaken, amen. But you know what this Bible said? Look what he said there. This man which built an house and dig deep and laid the foundation on the rock, look, and when the flood came, arose, and the stream beat vehemently upon the house, look what it says, it could not shake it, amen. Now I want you to know, friend, if your foundation's right, amen, I want you to know the flood's coming, amen. The streams are going to beat vehemently, amen. You know that means over and over and over again, amen. It's going to come time after time. I want to tell you, friend, it's going to use some pressure. I want to tell you, friend, it won't let up sometime for a while. But you know what the Bible said, amen. I like the part right there where he said this, amen, and could not shake it, amen. If your foundation's right, amen, you just make up your mind, amen, by the help and the grace of God, no matter what comes our way, amen, what we gonna do, we gonna go to God with it, amen, and God will help us to get through this together, amen. I want to tell you, friend, God will help you do that, amen, but you're gonna have to trust in a God, amen, that's able, friend. You're gonna have to submit to his sayings. You know what I found out, amen, the foundation's the Savior, amen. It'll help a whole lot, both of you being saved by the grace of God. You know what? When I got married, I wasn't a saved man. Amen. And I want to tell you, friend, we had a lot of rough times. Amen. You already got a real good start. Amen. With a testimony of being saved by the grace of God, I want to tell you that's a good place to start. Amen. Knowing that you know Him. Amen. And you're coming together in the perfect will of God. You know something? Now you have to determine, amen, no matter what comes our way, we're not going to let it shake. make us. Amen. I want to tell you, friend, when God joined man and woman together in holy matrimony, amen, that union between man and woman, amen, was a covenant made not only between them, but a covenant with God, amen. And in doing that, you know what I find out? That God will help you in spite of what comes your way if you'll trust Him and know that it's Him, amen, that's able to help you get through things that comes. Can I say, God designed marriage to be an unbreakable union between husband and wife. He used that one flesh relationship there, Brother Perry, how He took one, two and made one. And then, my friend, you know what He done, amen? He says, now they are to not let anything, they're not to let nothing, they're not to let any person. You know what I found now? It'll help you too a whole lot if you just understand outside the Lord Jesus Christ, there is not another person in this world as important as your spouse, amen? There's not another one, amen? Hey, that's exactly right, amen? Do you know what I found out? My wife, amen, she is above my mother, amen? She is above my father, amen? She's above my friends. She is the absolute number one outside the Lord Jesus, amen? I want to tell you, friend, if you ain't careful, there'll be some little friend come poking along, amen, and they'll try to get between you, amen, and steal that affection. And before you know it, you're spending more time, amen, with one of them than you are with your spouse, amen. And do you know what it does, amen? It breeds, amen. And before you know it, there is a wedge there. I want you to know that's right, amen. That foundation has to be right, amen. But his foundation was right. But notice something about his framework. He said, "Hear these sayings of mine." I said it last week, Brother Perry, amen. Do you know what? The marriage, amen. When it comes to marriage, the rules are God's rules, amen. And you're going to have to be willing to abide by God's rules, amen. You know what I found out? I want to say this, amen. You got to keep your faith right, amen. You got to keep your foundation right. I thought about it when I worded it that way today, Brother Jacob. It don't mean that you got to keep faith right, amen. It means you got to keep your faith right, amen. Your faith, amen. And trust God that He's going to keep her right, amen. I want you to know that's right, amen. We got a God in heaven, amen, that's able to help us. I want to tell you, friend, even though we've been saved for 21 years, married for 23 years, before number 24 comes, if we don't keep our foundation right, I want to tell you it could be all over with in one bad misunderstanding, amen. It don't take a whole lot, amen. I want you to know, my friend, but we determined a long time ago when problems arise, amen, you just deal with those problems and not, my friend, let them just act like they never happened, friend. You got to deal with them, amen. That's right, amen. Your foundation's right, amen. I know, amen, that He's able to help you, friend. Ain't gonna be times, amen, you wonder, how did it ever get here, amen? I never thought, you know what? Once you get married, amen, you're gonna see a side, amen, of your spouse you ain't ever seen before. Amen. You're going to see things that you didn't know about. Amen. You think it's all grand and glory. Amen. And it should be. But I want to tell you, friend, we told you last week there's a bad side that comes along with that good side. Amen. And when you said I do, you get good and bad. Amen. And you're going to have to learn to live with them. Amen. Because they're going to do things that irk you and aggravate you. Amen. If you ain't real careful, though, amen, you'll find yourself in a world of trouble. Amen. Keep your foundation right. In other words, amen, you know what, Brother Jacob, when things come up, I'm talking not only to them, I call his name, amen, because they're the ones about to get married, amen. But I want you to know that does us all good tonight, amen. When problems rise up, instead of fussing and bickering, amen, and throwing stuff at one another, amen, and uttering out things that you would to God you'd have never said, amen. I want to tell you, friend, that old devil's a liar, amen, and you know what he's good at doing. You'll think you got to get the last word in on everything. Amen. I'm talking about husband and wife. Amen. My wife used to make me so mad. Amen. She'd get something started. Amen. That's right, Sister Faith. She'd get something started. Amen. And then she would hush. Amen. While I did all the fussing. Amen. That's exactly right. Amen. But you know what I found out? That old devil, amen, he'll want you to get the last word in. Amen. He'll want you to make more out of it than what it is. is. And what you need to do is realize you got a foundation. You're going to have to dig real deep and understand that sometimes you are wrong. Amen. I want you to know the sooner you realize that, the better off you'll be. You ain't always going to be right, and you ain't always going to be right. Amen. But my friend, we're going to have to, I want to tell you some of the hardest words you'll ever say. But my friend, what you're going to have to learn real well is that I am sorry. Amen. Hey, going to be times in your life, in your married life, if you want to live happy ever after, you're going to have to be willing to say, I am sorry. Amen. Do you know what? If you ain't careful, you'll start saying things to your wife, amen, or to your husband, amen, to belittle them, amen. I want you to know that stuff builds up, amen. That's right, amen. That stuff builds up, amen. And it don't get any easier, amen. I want you to know, friend, tonight, you got to keep your foundation right in the midst of it all. But I want to give you something else. Turn to Ephesians chapter number 4. You got to keep your foundation right. Now, if you missed the foundation, you done missed everything. Amen. Know, amen, that you got a foundation. The winds are coming. Amen. The flood waters are rolling in. Amen. It's going to beat upon the house, Brother Perry, but you know what? There's a God in heaven, amen, that we can take any problem we've got to. It don't never get too big for him. It don't get too hard for him. I want to tell you, all of our problems could be solved if we would just do it God's way, and we would grab each, hey, that's right, and we'd bring it to the throne of God, amen, and say, God, you settle this, amen. I can't, you know what, we got to do that, amen. Realize, amen, he's a, but in Ephesians chapter number 4 and verse number 26, look what he said, or let's back up in verse number 24, he said, and that you put on the new man, which after God is created in righteousness and true holiness, wherefore putting away lying, speak every man truth with his neighbor, for we are members of one of another. Be ye angry and sin not, let not the sun go down upon your wrath, neither give place to the devil. I want to tell you, we've gave too much place to the devil, amen. He said, let him that stole steal no more, but rather let him labor, working with his hands the things which is good, that he may have to give to him that need it. Let no corrupt communication proceed out of your mouth. I want to tell you, friend, that's right. Amen. That includes the home life. Amen. That includes husband and wife relationship. Amen. He said, but that which is good to the use of edifying, that which may minister grace unto the hearers, and grieve not the Holy Spirit of God, whereby you are sealed to the day of redemption. Let all bitterness and wrath and anger and clamor and evil speaking be put away from you, and with all malice be kind one to another, tenderhearted, forgiving one another, as even as God for Christ's sake had forgiven you. What I'm interested in, amen, in that deal there is the fact of our communication or our fellowship, amen, is going to have to stay right, amen. I want to tell you, I've seen a lot of folk, amen, they just couldn't wait. Now listen, now I want you to know, amen, it's so easy now when you come down to the house of God and you've not seen each other in a few days, you want to spend all your idle time and spare time talking to one another and communicating with one another and telling all about how it sure is good to see you, amen. I'm glad, amen, that God put you in my life. But you just wait, amen, to the temptation the devil has. He'll try to steal your fellowship from you, amen. I've seen a lot of folk that get saved, that get married, amen, and they love each other head over heels over each other, amen. But they quit fellowshipping with one another. They quit communicating with one another. And before you know it, the husband goes off to work, amen, and he comes home beat, dead tired, comes home and grabs a lazy boy, and the wife, amen, sits over there being with kids all day, and she needs some adult communication, amen, and my friend will doze off into the next world, amen. That's right, amen. There's been a lot if we just learn to communicate. Can I say this tonight? It'll help you tonight, amen, if you'll let it, amen. Hey, comes a time in your life when you're there with husband and wife, it's time to put away the play toys. Amen. Somebody ought to say amen right there. Amen. It's time to put away the phones. Amen. It's time, amen, to turn off the television and just have a little talk with the spouse. Amen. I want to tell you, friend, hey, ain't nothing like pillow talk either. Amen. Some of the best talks I ever had. Amen. Is just laying there, amen, telling, amen, all about my troubles. Amen. And can I say this? Listening to her. her about all hers, amen. And my friend, we begin to talk in fellowship. That's right, amen. You ought to try it sometime, amen. Communicating and fellowshipping with your spouse, amen. It'll cause you to live happy ever after, amen. If you'll just fellowship with one another and make up your mind, I'm not going to let the devil, amen, get in the midst of this, amen, and steal my fellowship. Oh, my friend, can I say this tonight, amen? I want you to know many problems can be solved, amen, if husband and wife would just talk to each other. Just talk to each other. Sometimes, amen, it's nothing but more than a misunderstanding. Amen. She didn't say what you thought she said. He didn't say what you... He may have said something that you thought, amen, but he didn't mean it that way. Can I tell you, I got a way of putting words sometimes, amen. And sometimes I say something, I see my wife, I see that look. She may not say nothing, but I see that look. And I had to realize, amen, wait a minute, that ain't what I meant, amen. I want you to understand, amen. But you know what we have to do? You have to talk about those things, amen. Now listen what I'm trying to tell you tonight, friend. I want to say this is not the way to handle it, amen. The way to handle it, amen, is not to get all soiled up, amen. One of you get soiled up and roll over, and the other get poot-slip and go to pouting, amen. I want to tell you, it might quieten down for a little while, but the problem's not gone, and it will arise again, amen. That's exactly right. You better be sure to communicate and fellowship with one another, and let not the sun go down upon your wrath, amen. If you go to bed with it, you're getting back up with it the next day, amen, and it's going to be all over with there again. I want to tell you, friend, better learn to talk to each other, amen. There's been a lot, amen, that didn't make it because they didn't talk to each other, amen. Amen. Can I tell you, put away lying too, amen. Hey, can I go on and tell you, hey, ain't no place in a marriage, amen, for lying, amen. He said, put away lying, amen. Just be honest with one another, amen. I'm telling you that's right, amen. Ain't no little white lies, amen. A lie is a lie, amen. I want to tell you, don't try to cover it up. Just be honest with one another, straightforward with one another. Keep your fellowship right, and you know what? God will help you live happy ever after, amen. That's right, amen. Oh, that's right, amen. I want you to know, I'd just rather have the truth, amen. Amen. Can I say this? The whole truth and nothing but the truth. Amen. That's right. Amen. Think about it. That fellowship, right? Now, I thought about this. Amen. Not only do we got to keep our fellowship right, but we got to keep our forgiveness right. You know what? He said forgiving one another. In verse number 32 of Ephesians 4, is that what he said, Brother Brad? Forgiving one another. Now, can I go on and tell you something tonight? It might, you may not believe this, but you ain't perfect. Amen. Amen. I'm not perfect. You're not perfect. Amen. Your husband's not perfect. Your wife's not perfect. Your spouse is not perfect. Amen. And the sooner you realize that you're not perfect, the better off the two of you'll be. Amen. I want you to know. Amen. That's right. Amen. I want you to know, friend, do you know what he told him? That same principle applies. What you find in Matthew 18. And when he asked him how many times to forgive my brother, and he said 7 times. And he said, no, 70 times 7. Amen. In other words, he said, no, you forgive and keep on forgiving. Amen. I want you to know tonight, that's right. Amen. That's a word you better get well acquainted with if you're going to live happy ever after. Amen. You can't go around holding grudges on one another. Can I go on and tell you something else? Amen. You can't get full of bitterness. Amen. And always want vengeance. He did this to me and I'm going to do this to him. Amen. She did. Hey, my supper's cold. Amen. I'll see what she gets tomorrow. Amen. I want you to know that's right. Amen. We better understand, friend. We better get acquainted with forgiveness. Amen. And no, not only how to forgive, but how to forget about it. Amen. I want to tell you, when you deal with something, amen, when one of you mess up and one of you did wrong and one of you sinned against God, amen, and you get it right with each other, amen, I want to tell you, every argument you have from now to Jesus comes, it's not time to bring it back up again. Amen. If it's already been repented of and dealt with and put it under the blood, leave it there. Amen. No need to dragging it back out, talking about it again. It's already been dealt with. And it'll do more damage, amen, than it will good. Amen. I want to tell you, we better learn to fellowship with one another right. Learn to forgive right. But I want to say this, amen, in my last point here tonight. It's something I want you to get a hold of real good. You're going to have to learn to keep your finances right. Listen now. I have seen And I can tell you from experience the stress that it causes on a relationship between a husband and wife. In our younger years, most especially, amen, Brother Perry, amen, is finances will cause you some major troubles in your marriage life. Amen. I want you to know something, amen. Finances will cause you some major trouble. If you're not careful, amen, instead of death do us part, it'll be until debt do us part, amen. I want you to know that's right, amen. When you get married, amen, I want to tell you, friend, I want to read something here. In 1 Timothy chapter number 6, verse 6, he said, but godliness with contentment is great gain, for we brought nothing into this world, and it is certain we can carry nothing out. And having food and raiment, listen now, and having food and raiment, he didn't say food and raiment and a brand new truck and a brand new car and a brand new house, amen, and a four-wheeler and a gun, amen, and this and that, everything brand new all the time. Hey, ain't nothing wrong with some of those things in their place, amen, but when it comes to food and raiment, that comes first, amen. I want you to know that's right, amen. He said, in having food and raiment, let us be therewith content, but they that will be rich fall into temptation and a snare and to many foolish and hurtful lusts which drawn away in destruction and perdition, for the love of money is the root of all evil. For why some coveted after they have erred from the faith and pierced themselves through, listen, with many sorrows, amen. I want to tell you, friend, I want you to know, amen, there is something to this, amen. The Word of God has much to say about finances, amen. I want you to know that's right, amen. Money, amen, it has a lot to say about money, amen. I want you to know this. I wrote this down, amen. It has more than 1,000 verses, amen, dealing with money, amen. It tells you how to get it, amen. You ought to labor by the sweat of the brow, amen. I want to tell you, friend, that's still the right way to get it, amen. I want to tell you, he said, let him that stole steal no more, amen. If you want to get it God's way, amen. He tells you how to get it, amen. He tells you how to give it. He tells you how to save it. And he tells you how to spend it, amen. I want to tell you, if you ain't real careful, amen, you get them things out of order, and it's going to cause more stress in your home, amen, than you could have ever dreamed it would, amen. For you know it, you can't pay the light bill because you're trying to keep up with other things, amen, that you don't need and you ain't got to have, amen. I will say this tonight, amen. Credit card debt is the biggest one, amen. Do you know why it allows you to spend money you don't have most of the time for things you don't need, amen, and neither can you afford it, amen. Do you know what this sales pitch they got, amen? We'll give it to you 90 days without a payment, amen. I want to tell you, those first 3 months are wide open, amen. It sounds real good, amen. But can I tell you, day number 91's coming, amen. And when it does, it's got a payment attached with it, amen. And I want to tell you, friend, if you ain't careful, amen, you'll get so much in debt, amen, you can't even pay a light bill, amen. You don't know what you're going to eat this week, amen. You don't know how your house going to get paid, amen. I want you to know, amen, you better learn to be content, amen, with food and rain. Amen. Have it enough, amen. And then you know what? Can I go on and say this? Before there's ever any extras, amen, you better take care of the essentials, amen. Amen. You better take care of the essentials before there are any extras. Amen. Because they ain't. Now listen, friend. When we got married, amen, I was the free spender. Amen. And my wife, amen, she was conservative. She thought, amen, we had to save everything. Amen. I'm telling you, friend, we couldn't spend a nickel and dime on nothing. Amen. And you know what I thought? Amen. God put us together. Amen. And you know what I found out, Brother Brad? My being a free spender helps her with her conservativeness. Amen. Because there is a middle ground. Amen. You can have a whole lot of money and be miserable. Amen. But I want to tell you something else. Amen. Her conservativeness helped my free spending. Amen. She let me know. Amen. Look, we got a light bill coming up this week. Amen. You know what? You might could do this next week, but not this week, amen. We got house payment, light bill, amen. Garbage payment and everything else coming out this week, amen. I want to tell you, friend, your finances, amen, better be kept right, amen. Or it'll be the debt do us part, amen. If you ain't real careful, hey, I believe that, amen. If it ain't for long, amen, I want to tell you, you work 40 hours a week, you happy in Jesus, you're coming home to a warm house, amen, and a happy wife, and you fellowship and friend, and your foundation's right and you love Jesus, amen, then you get over held your head in debt, and my friend, you got to take a second job, amen. You're working 65 hours a week on one job, another 15 on another. You never see your wife, and when you do, she done went to bed and your food's cold, amen. You never fellowship anymore. I want to tell you, you sure did sell out, amen. A whole lot to get a little, amen. That's right, amen. Keep your finances right, amen. Don't get something you can't afford, amen. Let God be your helper, amen. And no, amen. It's important, amen, we keep these things in order. I want you to notice, Solomon was a wealthy man. Amen. Y'all remember Solomon, amen. Look with me. You remember God. Look with me in Proverbs 27 in a minute. I want you to turn there, but think about this. Your outgo can't never be more than your income. Amen. If your outgo's more than your income, you're going to be in trouble. Amen. You're going to be in trouble before it's over with. If you think, well, we're going to depend. Listen, I don't ever depend on anything that's not of a certainty. Amen. Well, we might get 60 hours next week. Well, you ever thought you might not? Amen. Amen. You start basing it on 60 hours. Amen. Before you know it, amen, you back down to 40. I'm telling you, I've worked jobs, amen, where they'll let you work 65 hours in the summertime and they'll starve you slap to death in the wintertime, amen, from 65 to 24, amen. I'm telling you, friend, you better find you a place, amen, that is a happy place. If you want the happy bells to ring in the home, you better keep your finances right, amen. I want to tell you, friend, don't ever spend more than what you got, amen. Listen now, I want to try to give you something tonight, amen. I want to tell you, remember, God promised to supply all your need. Amen. He said, but my God shall supply all your need according to his riches in Christ Jesus. Amen. I want to tell you, God, amen, if you'll honor him, he'll supply your need. I want to tell you, we ain't ever did without. Amen. My God's been good to me. Amen. God's been good to us. Amen. I say praise the Lamb of God tonight. Amen. He's always gave us what we needed. I praise his blessed name tonight. Amen. I don't know where we'd be without him. Amen. But my friend, I want you to know, friend, God never did promise to supply your greed. Amen. I want to tell you, you can get to wanting more than what you need. Amen. And before you know it, amen, can I tell you, amen, a lot of people blame God on something he didn't have nothing to do with. Amen. But you better know, amen, that God, amen, if he ordered it, he'll pay for it. Amen. Now listen, keep track. Look what he said in Proverbs 27. Proverbs 27 and verse 23, amen. I'm telling you from some experience, amen, in my life in the days gone by. Amen. When I got saved, when I got married, I wasn't even a saved man, amen. And I learned some things the hard way, amen. And I want to try to help some of us tonight, amen, especially these two young ones that's about to get married, amen. I want to tell you, friend, you better know that the days are ahead that financial stress will cause you a lot of trouble. That's a stress that you don't even have to have. That's one you don't need, amen, and you'd be better off without ever experiencing it, amen. But look what he said in Proverbs 27 and verse 23, I believe it is. Yeah, verse 23 and verse 24. Remember old Solomon, he said here, be thou diligent to know the state of thy flocks and look well on thy herds, for riches are not forever, and doth the crown endure to every generation. Look what he said, the hay appeareth, and the tender grass showeth itself, and herbs of the mountain are gathered. The lambs are for thy clothing, and the goats are for the price of the field. And thou shalt have goats, milk enough for thy food, for the food of thy household, and for the maintenance of thy maidens. Now, I want you to notice something. Solomon, y'all know Solomon was a wealthy man. He had silver and gold, brother. He had it. But I want you to know something. Solomon's day, amen, instead of having stock, they had flock. Amen. And they had to look well on that flock. They had to know the state of the affairs of the flock that they was watching over. In that, you know what the shepherd's deal was in that day, brother? He had to oversee the flock, amen, and he had to know the condition of that flock. He had to know how many he had. He had to know what he had. You just heard, amen, he said he's got to go supply for the maidens and everybody, amen. Now listen, amen, in doing that we'll find, amen, we're going to have to be aware of the state of our accounts. Amen. You ought to know what's in your accounts. Amen. Listen, can I say this while I'm here? They ought not be husband and wife account. Amen. You can't find that nowhere in the Word of God. Amen. Amen. I ain't got an account. My wife's got an account. We got one account. Amen. And it's ours together. Amen. And we try to manage that. Amen. For the glory of God. Amen. And I want to tell you, friends, sometimes it ain't easy. But I bless the name of the Lord tonight. Amen. That I don't have to fight with my wife over paying tithe. Amen. You ought to say amen right there. If you ever had to fight a spouse over that, you in a miserable place. Amen. I promise you are. I've seen some of them do it. Amen. But I want you to know, friend, I'll get there in a little while, amen, but I want you to think, have you ever said, I don't know where all the money goes? I don't know where all the money goes. Well, let's see, amen. You got your paycheck, you put it in the bank, and you're the only one writing checks off of it or using a debit card, amen. So you know what he told Solomon? He said, Solomon, you're going to have to keep track of things. Amen. In other words, amen, you're going to need a budget. Amen. You better know what you got in your accounts at all times. Amen. In other words, amen, you know what you deposited. And if you ain't real careful, now listen, I'm going to tell you, amen, this is right. Amen. If you ain't careful, you'll deposit your paycheck. Amen. You'll pay a few bills and you'll have things you don't even need. And then you are dependent on, what is that thing they call overdraft protection, amen, the next payday, amen. You don't have to live that way. Amen to God, you don't have to live that way, amen. If you'll just know the state of your accounts, amen. If you'll just keep track of what you got, amen. I want you to know you need to keep track of what you earn, amen. You know what you bring in, amen. Amen, you know what you have. Listen now, not only what you earn, amen, but you know what you owe. Amen. Ain't nobody knows what you owe like you know what you owe. Amen. And you know what you bring home, you know what you owe. So when you bring it home, pay your bills. Listen, friend, you don't want to call every 2 days, amen, done and you over a bill, amen, that you created you can't pay for because you want to drive a four-wheeler all the time. Amen. Now listen, friend, you understand this tonight, what you earn, what you owe. Listen to this, where it goes. Know where it goes. Listen, you'd be surprised at how foolish you spend money, amen, if you don't keep a track where it goes, amen. If you ain't careful, amen, you will have invested unknowingly to you $19 a week, amen, or $19 a day in Coca-Cola Company, amen. Amen. You know what? Amen. Ain't nothing wrong with having a Coca-Cola. I ain't preaching against having a Coca-Cola. Amen. But I want to tell you, friend, if it gets so tight, if whether it's going to be my $80 a month worth of Coca-Colas, amen, or whether my family's going to eat, I think we're going to eat. Amen. You got to know where it goes. Amen. I keep track of where you're spending. Amen. I want to tell you, friend, you ought to know what you own too. Amen. You ought to know what you own, amen. Keep a good record of what you got, amen. He was telling Solomon there, he said, I want you to keep a track of what you have, amen. And I want you to do with it wisely, amen. I want you to deal with your finances in a wise way. I want you to be able to take care of your family, amen. I want you to know, folks, God wants us to be able to take care of our families, amen. And God has a plan for that. Keep track of what you have, amen. Keep track of what's going on in your life, Brother Brad. Think about this, amen. I want to say this to you. Financial freedom is never determined by what you make. It is determined by what you spend. Come on. Amen. It's not what you... Listen, I know folks that make six figures a year that can't even get out of debt. Amen. And I know folks, amen, making $20,000 a year, amen, doing just fine. Amen. It ain't determined by, amen, how much you make. These people always chasing another dollar, and we've got to have this many hours, and we've got to have this, and we got to get this, and we're going to work all these hours, and we're going to get a bigger paycheck, amen. You wouldn't have to do all that if you'd cut down on your foolish spending, amen. That's right, amen. That's what he's trying to tell us. Keep track of it, amen. Look what he said in Proverbs 21 and verse 20. Proverbs 20, keep your finances right. If I could give, Brother Jacob, if I could give y'all any advice tonight, I would say keep your finances right. Keep yourself out of debt, amen. I want to tell you, friend, keep yourself out of debt, amen. Just cause, listen, don't ever go out and do something on the spur of the moment, amen. That spur of the moment spending will get you in trouble, amen. Always be, look, what you ought to do is think about it a little while, amen. You know what I thought, man, you know what? I heard one man say, you know what? Me and my wife's going to have plastic surgery, amen. And they said, what do you mean? He said, we're going to go home and cut up some credit cards. Amen. I want to tell you, friend, if you don't know how to control it, you'd be better off cutting them up. Amen. That's right. Amen. Because you better know that payment's coming at the end of the month. Amen. And I want to tell you, friend, if you ain't careful, you put 20 on this and 30 on that and 40 on this, and before you know it, you got so much debt you can't get out of. Amen. And you and your wife sitting around bickering all the time because you can't do this and you can't do that. I want to tell you, friend, I want to say this. It's all right. Amen. And it's pretty nice. I want to tell y'all something tonight. It's nice, Brother Jacob, every now and then, once a week or once every couple of weeks, to be able to take your wife, amen, especially if it's Lord's will, them little children come along and go out somewhere and eat, amen, for the glory of God. And I want to tell you, get her out of the kitchen, praise the Lord, and be able to do that and just go out and just treat her to a good dinner, amen. And I want to know, friend, I want you to know you can't do that, amen, if you spend foolishly, amen. You'd be better off spending that dollar with her and the children, amen, out there somewhere. I want to tell you, friends, sometime. Now listen, friends, sometimes, amen, I would like it to be Cracker Barrel, but we'd better be satisfied with McDonald's. Yeah, say amen right there. But I want to tell you what, to her, McDonald's is still better than to have to be in the kitchen every day of the week. Amen. Amen. That's right. And them kids like Happy Meals too, but I want to tell you, friend, they'll eat a dollar burger in a hurry. Amen. I want to tell you. But you know what? It's a whole lot of good time. It's not that dollar burger going in our mouth, amen, as it is sitting around that table, amen, laughing and cutting up and having a good time, amen, when we go out to eat. Amen. That's right. Now, Proverbs 21:20. I'll try to get over there. Amen. I want to show you something. Proverbs 21 and verse, I think I got it the wrong way. Amen. Let me see what I wrote down here. But it's in Proverbs. I know that. Amen. I wrote down 21:20, and I'm not even sure, amen, where I was going, but it's talking about the foolish. Let me see if that's right. Proverbs 21 and verse number 20. I want to tell you, keep your finances right. And verse number 20, look what he said. He said, there is treasure to be desired in oil in the dwelling of the wise, but a foolish man spendeth it up. Amen. That's what he said. See, Solomon, he's a wise man, brother. And he said, I want to tell you, friend, there's some treasures to be had, but a foolish man will spend everything he's got. I mean, friend, if he's got a nickel, he's going to spend it. I want to tell you, friend, I've tried to teach my children. Now, Dustin, boy, I want to tell you, I try not to use him. He don't like that too much, amen. But I want to tell you, friend, you get him a nickel and he's going to spend it, amen. You give Ben one, amen, he'll try to get another one to go with it, amen. That's right, amen. I want to tell you, friend, always looking for something else, amen. Want more, I'm going to hold on to this a little while, amen. I want to tell you, friend, you know what, though? He has collected over the years, amen, multitudes, amen, a lot of knives, amen. And to me and his mama, sometimes that's just a big pile of knives, amen. But you know what? He's got some in there worth a few dollars, amen. And you know what he's told a time or two ago? I wouldn't get rid of them for nothing. And he always says, right now. Hey, I'm saving them up for a day. Amen. And I want to tell you something, friend. It'll help us tonight to know you don't have to spend everything you got. Amen. Amen. Hey, listen, have you ever thought about it this way? Most people carry the idea, well, we got an extra $50 this week. We got to go find somewhere to spend it. I want to tell you, have you ever thought that God might have sent that extra $50 this week for next week? Amen. Now listen, I'll give you something else here and we'll close in Proverbs chapter 6. Proverbs chapter number 6, I want you to look at this. God even taught the ant how to save. He said, go to the ant, thou sluggard. Consider her ways and be wise. Look at this, which having no guide. They ain't even got a guide. You and I got one. I got one. His name is the Holy Ghost. The Holy Spirit of God came to guide us into all truth. Amen. Who having no guide, overseer, or ruler, provided her meat in the summer and gathereth her food in the harvest. You see what I'm saying there? And gathereth her food in the harvest. I want to tell you, you know what an ant does? An ant will save it up. There's going to be sometimes in your life you just need to save it up. You know what I want to tell you, friend? Sometimes it's difficult in finances. I want to tell you, this world today, they've got it set up where they think that you got to have two people working all the time, 40 and 60 and 80 hours a week to make it work. But I want to tell you, friend, you don't have to go down that road. Amen. If you'll honor God, amen, God will honor you. Amen. But you're going to have to do it God's way, and you're going to have to not go foolishly spending everything you have. Just save it up, amen, for the day coming, amen. I want to tell you, friend, you need to be in a place, amen, when something... Listen, friend, it ain't that way for us all the time either. There's times, amen, things happen, and we think, would to God, I don't know how we're going to pay for this. You ever been there? Amen. I have. I'm telling you what, if transmission goes out this week, we'd be like, word to God, I don't know what we're going to do. But you know what, Brother Perry? There is times, amen, when things go out, the water pump goes out, we can pay for it.
Right.
Amen. We'll pay for it, amen. You know why? Because God taught us a little bit about not just spending every nickel that we come across, amen, all the time.
Right.
Amen. Sometimes, amen, it'll get that way, amen. You'll be done spent more than what you got coming in, but listen, just try to keep your finances right. If you keep your finances right, then it sure will help that fellowship stay right. Yes, it will, amen. Because I'm going to tell you, that fellowship ain't going to stay right if your finances get out of order. Because all you'll want to do is sit around and talk about money. Amen. You'll want to start talking about money all the time, amen. And before you know it, amen, you got your whole family in an uproar, amen, and don't know what you're going to do tomorrow, amen. I want to tell you, there's nothing more pleasing. Brother Jacob, I'm going to call, Brother Jacob ain't offended by that, amen. I call his name, amen, because he's about to get married. He's about to take on a whole new responsibility. Amen. I want you to know, amen, there ain't nothing more that a wife needs to know than that she's going to be provided for. Amen. And ain't nothing more than a husband needs to know than his wife is going to submit and reverence, amen, and follow him. Amen. That's right. Amen. In the will of God. And it'll help you, amen, to keep some things right. You can live happy ever after. Amen. It ain't just in the fairy tales. Amen. It is in real life, amen. You can live with the one that God, amen, joined you together with, amen, and be happy about it, amen. I'm happy. I'm going to just tell you this, and we'll be done. I'm more happy tonight about it than I was when we got married, amen. That's right. Praise God. Everybody, remember, I say it with a smile, amen, and mean it, amen. That's right, amen.